fortnight ago. A bitter feud has developed between the Ulster Volunteer Force and the breakaway Loyalist Volunteer Force. The LVF has told RTE it will avenge the deaths of the teenagers, whom they believe were murdered by a UVF gang from Belfast.
Paul McIlwain knows his 18-year-old son David was an innocent victim of this Loyalist feud. He was brutally murdered alongside 19-year-old Andrew Robb last month. Andrew, pictured here with the blonde hair behind the murdered LVF leader Billy Wright, was accused of being a member of that organisation. In years to come, his daughter Megan will find out her father was killed in a way reminiscent of the Shankill Butchers.
Andrew's throat was cut from the nape of his neck right round till his ear. He had a chunk missing out of his lip. He had a gash across his eye and round the side of his head and the back of his head, as far as I could see, was full of holes.
It's generally agreed they were murdered in retaliation to the LVF killing of Portadown UVF commander Richard Jameson. Weeks before his death, Richard Jameson became a marked man after a fight broke out in a social club between UVF and LVF supporters. Tension is so bad in the town that bars remain empty at night. This afternoon, a senior loyalist source very close to the LVF leadership said the deaths of the two boys will be avenged. He said the people responsible will be targeted and dealt with. He warned they will not be around for too much longer. But the UVF's arms go-between has dismissed the threat.
Well, I'm actually standing here quaking in my boots thinking about the LVF going to deal with anybody. I mean, the LVF can do what they like. That's up to the LVF. At the moment, there are only two people who have died, as far as I'm concerned, two people in our party.
What's your opinion of the LVF?
My opinion is that they're a bunch of gangsters, drug dealers and thugs, and they should be driven out of Portadown and everywhere else in this province.
To complicate matters even further, the former UFF commander Johnny Adair has sided with the LVF. A source close to him said he was prepared to go to town on this feud. Only last week a death notice appeared in a Belfast newspaper for a UVF man who is still alive and well. Andrew Robb's mother wants her son's killers caught.
I hope they suffer. Andrew and David suffered. And I hope they suffer.
The reality is this feud has little to do with loyalism. It's more a Portadown turf war, a battle for control of drugs and racketeering. With two AK-47 rifles gone missing from a mid-Ulster loyalist arms dump, the fear is there's more violence to come. Michael O'Kane, RTÉ News, Portadown.